Each and every day, 380,000 cubic meters of wastewater is purified. From the Shafdan plant, through the conduction lines of Mekarot, 140 million cubic meters of potable water reach the agricultural fields in the south of Israel, an amount equal to 10% of the water consumption in Israel. The water, pure and clear, reaches a full circle and returns to nature.
We're standing in the center on a glass. Paper, what do you give us? Waste, organic Now, inside that wastewater, 40 tons of garbage, solid. To take the solid out of the wastewater, we have the bar screens, the pre-treatment. Basically use huge cones that separate the solid from the water. This is how they look in real life. Soon, we'll see how they really work. This is how it looks. Very beautiful. Here we go, there is the scum. Here's a close-up. And another one. Oh, very on it. And it all goes out to a big trash container. From a trash container by truck, or to recycling, or to the dumping site. We cannot separate oils, fats, sand, or small stones in this fashion. And that's why we have the waste in basins. Basically, water panels. Water stands still, oils and fats, what do? Float, they don't go up, okay. It's just float. And sand and small stones, what do? Sinks and settle, very good. Then when it happens naturally, this blue grid goes, skims the fats and the oils out to a big fat and oil container. And truck will take it to the nearby plant called Reclamation. Reclamation will recycle the oils and the fats to biodiesel, energy for the industry. The sand and the grit will be removed by small RPVs pumps and then to the trash container. Finally, we can start purifying the water. Biological reactors. All the wastewater and nitrogen are here. And then we have pathogenic diseases, we have the ammonia, we have the good bacteria that digest. What will you do? This thing is actually separated to three stages: aerobic, anaerobic, and anoxic. With oxygen, without oxygen, and with certain levels of oxygen. To get rid of the pathogenic bacteria, the dead ones that cause diseases, the ammonia will eventually come, the nitrate will become free to the atmosphere, and the most of the bad stuff, the organic material, will be digested by the bacteria itself. And this is how the material looks. The sludge, as you see here, this mud on the water, this is the slab. These are billions of microorganisms that we just saw in the microscopes. They ate, grew larger, stuck to one another, and then they look to us like sludge. This process will take 17 hours here. And then we have a lot of secondary effluent and bacterias, sludge. We need to insert one thing only, oxygen. That is why we have filled aerators that insert oxygen to the aerobic stages and anoxic stages as much as we need. This is how it looks, the schematics. And after 17 hours, all the secondary effluent and the bacteria are going to the settling basin. And this is how it looks. Brown, black, the sludge, the bacteria, the microorganisms. They settle, they sink in the settling basin. This is how they look. Right, I'll stop right here so all of you can take this picture. I feel like I'm sorry. Bacteria sank and we have secondary effluent here. What is the secondary effluent? It is this liquid. This liquid we have under one day here in this facility. Secondary effluent you cannot drink yet or shower in it. Always be conveyed in purple pipes in Israel. All the other wastewater treatment plants in Israel produce only secondary effluent. So what would we do with it if you cannot drink it or shower with it? They use it for the grass, the fountains in the cities, the cotton fields, the flower industry, the fire department. Sometimes you can even use it for oranges, watermelons, and so forth. Here in the Shafdan, we're the only ones in Israel, almost the only ones in the world, maybe a few others, that takes this liquid and transforms it to potable water. Actual water you can actually drink and shower. It's amazing. How do we do it? First, we need to take the sludge out. sludge will be conveyed out by big Archimedes pumps. They will go into the water, raise the water level, the sludge will stick to them, they will spin up and take the sludge out with them. The water goes down because of gravity. 70% of the sludge will be returned to the biological reactors, returned activated sludge system, this is this plant, and 30% we have too much, so we need to take it and transform it to organic fertilizer. This is the solution. So, sludge extraction, and then we have the centrifuges and the GVTs that will thicken the sludge to 20% and to the digesters. The digesters will be here in the future, 2015. Right now, we're using Enviro. Coal, ash, and lime to transform into organic fertilizer. In the future, we'll use the digesters. We'll be able to take more sludge and deal with everything. Then, the secondary effluent goes out in purple pipes to the recharge basins, the SAT, basically soil aquifer treatment. What happens there? We flood it with secondary effluent. The water will filtrate through the field 30 to 50 meters for 400 days, more than a year. Its contamination will be stayed in the sand, bacteria will digest, and then after 400 days, we pump it out as reclaimed water. Just as potable water. Water from the tap in this bottle and the recycled water. As you can see, in our eyes, don't drink it and eat it. Looks the same, tastes the same, even smells the same, and even under a microscope, they're very similar. That is why we can use it for shower to drink, such as they do in Singapore, or in Israel, for the agriculture in the south, for fruits and vegetables that we eat and send to Europe. Amazing. How much did it cost us to take 1 cubic meter, 1,000 liters, or 464 gallons of wastewater? And transform it to 1 cubic meter of potable water, it cost us 1 shekel. This is like 20 American cents. Okay? For 1 cubic meter, 1,000 liters. Yes. 1,000 liters, 1 shekel. It's very cheap. Not only green, but very cheap. And this is why delegations from all over the world are coming here and they're interested in this facility. They're building it.
One bottle costs 5 shekels.
In the supermarket. Of course. 1 shekel for 1,000 liters is how much it costs us. We here, we give it freely. Free, we're an NPO, non-profit organization. We give it for free to the agriculture in the south. It's not going back to the supermarket. In the supermarkets, you have private companies taken over a lake, pumping it out for very cheap, even less than 1 shekel, because they don't really need to purify it. Okay, it's costing them like 20 cents, I think, or 30 cents. So the bottle you drink from the supermarket, yes, they pump it from the river or the streams, they purify it a bit, cost them about 20 or 30 agolot, it's like less than 10 American cents, and then they sell it for 5 shekels, 10 shekels, or more. Private company. We're here to help the environment, so we're giving it for free to the agriculture in the south. Yes? It's a good question. You get the water, your product, for free. So where do you get the money to go? We get it from tax. Each citizen, each household in that region pays wastewater tax. And then it comes here, this is how we help it. It's a municipal ownership. The seven big cities. Yes, the seven big cities founded association and regional association. And then this is how it works. Yes. The size of the total investment so far, because we're always building more, $8 billion so far. So far. 1955, taking you back, when we started this facility, we had oxidation plants. We didn't have this modern facility. We just started out, and we needed a lot of money to build it. So
So what did we do? We took municipal money, tax, raise tax. We took loans from banks, world banks. Then we use investments. We have all kinds of funds. We have Christian funds, Jewish funds, United Nations funds from the World Bank that invest in small, poor countries as we were in the past. And then we started building this, but we returned the investment. We returned the money that we took to begin with. Zanzibar that came here just 2 weeks ago, delegation, they're doing the same thing. They don't have the funds to build this thing. So the Israeli company is showing them around, going to the World Bank, the United Nations, and then they should get the fund to build it on their own soil.
So how long did it take to return the investment?
To return the investment, it took us, at least us here in that region, Israel, about 20 years.
Yes. So, you say that all this process goes to agricultural things, right? And where comes the water from? The restrooms or the kitchen, I don't know. Where
the
comes
kitchen, the restrooms.
But where it comes from?
Where it comes from?
Here.
I got your question. You're asking where do you get water to drink, to shower? Yes, that's what you're asking. The water we shower and drink, we have several, maybe I'll show you here, several options. How many indicators? We test a lot of things. I will show you the table right now. right away. Who tests them? We test the water 4 times a day in every stage. Very important to us to know how it's working, if it's really working, really purified. Then you have the EPA, the Environmental Protection Agency or office in Israel, that also samples the water. Then we have the health department that also comes here and samples the water. And obviously we have inspectors from the city itself to inspect the water. Then, as I heard, the farmers themselves, when they get the water, they check it before they use it. So we check a lot of times. What exactly do we check? I will show you right now, the table. I'll just show you a bit. We send fields, soil aquifer treatment, outside of this plant, from Rishon to Ashdod, 1,000 dunams. This is how it looks. And then this is how it looks inside, going in, 400 days, 30 to 50 meters. Material stays inside, and then we pump it out. And now we're going to see the real plant and the real machine.
I hope it's a good day today. Seems like it. We will find out soon enough.
Basin 1 out of 12, what happens here? Here what you see, this is the secondary effluent. This is why it smells better. After 1 day we have it here. At the beginning of the plant, we have 20 bar screens that will separate 40 tons of solids every day. Why do we have them again here? Because the pools are open. A pigeon can rest in peace here. To the sludge that we took out. 70% of the sludge will be returned to the activated system, to the biological reactors, the big pools with all the water in them, and so we always have a lot of the good bacteria. 30% we need to recycle.